In embedded software and hardware development, the earlier you test, the better your product. If you are interested in how to set up a VIO system to speed up your testing, stay tuned. Hello, I'm Jan Grünewald and I work on test solutions at Vector. Testing embedded software and hardware is becoming more relevant in the early stages of their development. And that's where Vector's VIO system joins the party. It's an entry-level I/O hardware system broadly applicable for testing and controlling of embedded devices. With its attractive price and size, it's perfect to find its way straight to any developer workspace. In this video, I will show you the VIO system and explain it step by step to make it even easier for you to get started. The system is ideally suited for a wide range of applications, such as continuous testing and simulation in all development stages. The compact housing fits on any office desk or in any hardware-in-the-loop test environment. It offers space for a variety of powerful I/O cards that allow you to test basically any embedded system, even in the microsecond range. The VIO system is shipped with the following main components: the rack with power supply and host uplink card, and slots for application-specific I/O cards. Depending on your configuration, these slots may contain cards or be closed with blank panels. Then there's the VIO system tool for easier installation and removal of cards. At one end is a Torx bit for tightening or loosening the screw connections. At the other end is the card extractor, which can be used to pull cards out of the rack by their screw heads. Of course, a power supply cable and Ethernet cable for communication is also provided. These main components are completed with a leaflet that bundles all the initial information for a quick start. Now, let's have a look at the VIO system in detail. The rack is available in two different sizes. The small version, which we have here, has 7 I/O card slots, while the larger version provides 12. And if you need even more space, daisy chaining of up to 10 racks is also supported. The whole device comes standard with a 40 watts power supply card connected to a 240 to 24 volts power brick. The host uplink card is also always included. It's used to connect the rack to a computer on which, for example, test procedures are executed. In between, the remaining slots can be equipped with application-specific I/O cards. In this setup, only one I/O card is used to which we will connect the device under test. So far, that's all the theory. Let's dive into a practical example. For a simple demonstration, we would like to test this device. You wonder, what's that? It's red LEDs. And what does it do? Obviously, it will turn red. So to do that, we attach the wires of our super special device under test to the included Phoenix connector. Then we plug the black Phoenix connector into the stimulation card VIO 2004 and the green one into our device. To use the VIO system, a computer running Canoe is connected via Ethernet. Canoe is our tool for configuration, test execution, and analysis. As soon as everything is connected, we can get started. In Canoe, we start the measurement and test configuration that controls the LEDs. All of them light up, so our really complex device has passed our even more complex test. Of course, significantly more complex controls and tests, including fully automated ones, are also possible. As you have just seen, our compact and cost-attractive VIO system can be set up in just a few steps. With its variety of cards, it's suitable for a wide range of applications. Together with Vector's Canoe, it builds a versatile and scalable test system regardless of the development state of your hardware. Now is the right time to get your hands on and setting up your own VIO system. Have fun and thanks for watching. If you are interested in more videos about the VIO system, check out our playlist. To take a deep dive into the software config, please subscribe our Vector channel and activate the bell to not miss any new videos. See you soon!